Oh my god. Why am I scared right now? This is not supposed to be scary.
Welcome to ConTECHtual, where we show you the history and future of all the tech that you're coveting or using right now.
Are you sick of this reality?
Oh god, yes.
So am I, and because of that, we're going to be talking about virtual and augmented realities. Virtual realities take place on a screen in a digital world, and augmented realities are projected on the real world in front of you, usually through your screen, pretty much on your smartphone. They both go back way longer than you think, too. For example, in 1835, we got the stereoscope. It was the coolest virtual reality of the 19th century. They were essentially goggles that you wore on your face with lenses and duplicate images to transport the wearer to another location, or at least to convince people in the 1800s that they were transported to another location, but they also believed in witches. What are you doing?
I'm transported.
That's not how this works. It's not any goggles, they're stickers. Those are stickers on the goggles.
That's what you think.
Okay, sure. In 1929, people built this thing that passed for a flight simulator. And in 1962, a filmmaker named Martin Halig patented the Sensorama Simulator. A crazy arcade cabinet with a 3D screen that took up your entire field of vision. It had vents for wind and smell, and a vibrating seat. The games included A Date with Sabina.
Hence the vibrating seat.
You can't have A Date with Sabina without a vibrating seat. And weirdly enough, something called I'm a Coca-Cola Bottle.
Also for the vibrating seat?
Probably to simulate carbonation.
Myron Kruger brought some of the first augmented reality with Video Place. It was a crazy art project that used holograms, projections, cameras, and other technology to put a user in a space where they could interact with the art, including interacting with some of the other users from another room via hologram.
That's pretty impressive.
Which brings us to modern VR. We went to VR World to play around a bit.
VR World is a center for virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. Our mission is to make it more accessible, to make it accessible in general to the mainstream audience.
It's more than gaming.
Yeah, totally. I mean, the gaming community, of course, they're gonna love virtual reality, right? It's like gaming on steroids. But we wanted to do something that was beneficial for everyone and also showcase the storytelling power that this medium has.
You're right in the
I'm sorry.
Dan, I got your six.
Remember,
what the? Oh,
attacked,
oh God!
Ah! Oh! That's not.
This is not supposed to be scary.
Oh my God! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Okay, it's just floor. It's just floor, guys. Woo! Wow!
That. I'm done.
You really feel like you're not on the ground.
But VR tech can go beyond just making Dane scream like a teensy tiny little baby man.
All right.
So we're talking to Dr. Justin Barad via robot. He's a pediatric orthopedic surgeon who used his interest in video game development to co-found Osso VR, a virtual reality training software for surgeons. What is Osso?
It's a surgical training platform that you could use anytime and anywhere that allows you to practice a procedure before you operate on a patient, which is kind of a novel concept.
So what makes VR such a crucial tool for the medical field?
Students basically that were trained with VR operated at twice the performance level of non-VR trained students, which is a larger effect than we thought.
My last question is, what is your vision? How do you see the future of the medical field changing as more and more people start using this tech?
If you've ever traveled around the world in like medical missions or Doctors Without Borders, you'll see that, you know, a lot of times these regions have very, very intelligent, capable people, but they don't have the training infrastructure and resources that we do here. So this is an incredible option that allows you to roll out like, you know, cutting edge surgical training in a global way. Really on the verge of an interesting kind of a revolution in how you know, you basically go and see someone and eventually get surgery and recover afterwards. And you know, the whole process is gonna be much more exciting, streamlined, safer, and effective.
And of course, we still don't know if our own reality is some kind of virtual one put up for us by robots, like in that movie, The Matrix.
Which would make all of existence completely meaningless.
But we'll see you next week, where we'll dive into 3D printing.